I'm just a shipyard worker, but I've got a worker's pride when I see a vessel rising in the stocks. And when the job is finished and she floats out on the tide, I shout another winner for the jocks. And it's Clyde built, man, there's no ship afloat could ever had the Connolly a Clyde built boat. Clyde built, and British through and through, and like the men that build them staunch and true. From Govan to Dumbarton, we're earning our bobbies, building masterpieces to sail the seven seas. I am the Clyde built. Search the world wide, you can't get them better than we build them on the Clyde. The Germans tried their level best to steal the prize of war, and the Frenchmen built the Normandy, it's true. But when it comes to handing out the medals for the best, you've got to give the credit where it's due. And it's Clyde built, man, there's no ship afloat that could ever had the Connolly a Clyde built boat. Clyde built, and British through and through, and like the men that build them staunch and true. The MacGregors, the MacCullochs, the MacDonalds and McQueens are turning out the answer to the German submarines. I am the Clyde built. Search the world wide, you can't get them better than we build them on the Clyde.
It's all right, it's all right. We know what we're doing. We know what we're doing. You don't need to tell us what to do. We're turning out the ships all right.
Of course, there's been a lot of criticism in the newspapers about the shipyard workers, can't I?
Have you read the criticisms about us fellows? No? Jolly clever. I think they're a right gallus lot, that. We don't mind being criticised if it's fair. There's only one critic we want to get hold of in the shipyard here. That's the man that wrote on the side of the dockyard wall, "Never has so little been done by so many in such a hell of a long time." That's a wee bit below the bell. Because I must admit, we're a right gallus lot, you know. But we get a good laugh even when we're working hard. With a great laugh on Tuesday with big Jimmy McCulloch. Great big fella, 6 foot, 4 and a half. He fell 70 feet into the hold of one of these ships that we're building. Broke both legs, 4 ribs and his shoulder blade. The funniest thing I've ever seen in my life. Because it was his ain fault, walking along on the top deck in the blackout, 3 o'clock in the morning, with his hands in his pockets. That was his big mistake. There's nobody allowed to have their hands in their pockets. Except the foreman. Jimmy was walking along the top deck with his hands in his pockets, looking up at the sky, thinking about the football match on Saturday. Down he went. 70 feet, I saw him go. 70 feet, and he didn't hesitate 1 second from the moment he left the stop till he hit the bottom. Broke both legs, 4 ribs and his shoulder blade. So we sent him to the Royal Infirmary at 3 o'clock in the morning. And at 3:30, the dock policeman had to break the news to his wife, Mrs. McCullough. You can imagine the fright the wee woman got. Waking up out of a sound sleep at 3:30 in the morning, her man at work and seeing a big policeman at the door, you know. So the big policeman looked at her, he said,
"Are you Mrs. McCullough?"
You know, the kindly way the police have. She said, "Yes, that's me." "Well, he says, I've come to tell you your husband's fallen 70 feet into the hold of a ship, broken both legs, 4 ribs and his shoulder blade. He's in the infirmary." She said, "Heavens, is that what it is?" You give me an awful fright. I thought I was showing a light. That's the spirit of the women of Scotland. Oh, but with another big laugh on Tuesday, with wee Geordie Brown, a wee burly-legged fella drives a horse in a lorry. He was coming down to the dock with a load of steel last Tuesday, and they noticed it was 5 minutes to closing time. So as any other driver of a horse in a lorry would do in Scotland, he stopped his horse. He thought he'd knock off a bucket, you see. Well, he wanted somebody to have his horse for a couple of minutes. Of course, there was nobody about at that time. They were all in, you see. But coming round the corner, he saw a wee fat man with a dark overcoat on and a bowler hat. You know, a Glasgow business gentleman. You know, you've seen them, you know. Now, with a pair of those square-toed boots they wear to get nearer to the bar with. Well, he stopped this wee man. He says, "Hey, mister, would you mind hitting my horse for a couple of minutes?" The wee man looked at him. He said, "Don't you realize that I'm a town councillor?" "Oh, wee Geordie," says, "I'm sorry about that, sir. I didn't realize that. A town councillor? Oh, that's different, but... Ah, heaven, surely I can trust you with a horse and a lorry." I tell you, we're a right gala slot. There's no mistake about it. We're hearts in the right place, and we're doing a job of work with our sleeves rolled up. And there's one thing, we can keep our mouths shut. We can keep a secret. You remember the big ships that left the Clyde during the war and got safe to the other side of the Atlantic? And not one cheap a booty. Something to be proud of that, you know. Keep a secret. A secret. Heavens, I had a sweetheart in the dock for years the wife didn't know anything at all about. Sure. And I'll tell you all about her, too. She was just a growing lassie when I met her in the dock. My sweetheart. But I never felt the wife. And the boys all loved her, too. She was British through and through. A lady that we'll love all through her life. Man, it was a bonny, bonny day when our sweetheart sailed away out across the ocean with her bonny coat of grey. As maybe one or two of you boys here remember that day. You remember when our royal lady came from Buckingham Palace with the king, her husband, and stood amongst us working lads just as if they were one of the family. And he patted me on the back. He did that. Man, you know, it was quite pathetic, you know that? But the most pathetic sight that day was to stand there amongst thousands of Scottish shipyard workers and watch the expression on their faces when a whole bottle of good stuff went bang up against them. It was a bonny royal day when our sweetheart sailed away, a lady that we'll all love to the death. But when peace comes through the rain, she'll come sailing back again, our bonny royal queen, Elizabeth. There's no ship afloat that could ever hold a candle to a Clydebelt boat. Clydebelt and British through and through, and like the lads that build them, staunch and true. From Dublin to Dumbarton, we're earning newer bodies, building masterpieces to sail the seven seas. I am that Clydebelt. Search the world wide, you can't get them better than we build them on the Clydebelt.
Goodbye. Good luck to you.